past the scripture. And a lot of times people use it. And it says that he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
Yeah.
See, the thing we're supposed to understand about that particular passage of scripture, the great apostle Pundit L. Wilson, he taught me this. And he said that particular passage also is a military term.
Yeah.
It was a military term used in a time of war.
Yes. Yes.
When in a time of war, the number one man in charge will go to the king's secret chamber.
Yeah.
And in that king's secret chamber, in there, that king will reveal his plan of attack.
Yeah.
And once that plan of attack has been revealed, that number one man in charge will come out of that secret chamber and go in the authority of that king.
Yeah.
Go into the authority of that master, of that leader, of that king. Say amen.
Amen.
See, the thing you must realize about God is that when you really are close to God, see, the thing about a secret place with God, a relationship with God, it's an intimate situation. It's an intimate place wherein that God reveals his mind, that God reveals his heart, that God reveals his ways. That's just like in a natural relationship between couples. When you're in a dating, when you're trying to get to know that particular person, you'll spend time with them. You will go to the park. You will go to the movies, and you will watch TV, and you will do all kind of things. And what you're doing, you'll learn how they think.
Yes.
You'll learn their ways, how they respond,
yeah,
and given situations. You'll know what they will do, and what they sound like, and what they don't sound like. See, that's an intimate place.
Yeah.
And see, now flip this thing over to God. See, when you're in the intimate place, when you're in the secret place of God, what God will do, God will reveal to you his plan.
Right.
God will reveal to you his mind.
Right.
God will reveal to you his plan of attack.
Yeah.
Which means that you don't have to fear. You don't have to be troubled because God got you. And God's going to lead you beside the sea of water.
Yeah.
Just like Elijah. When Elijah did what God said, when he showed heaven. When he showed heaven, God already spoke to him.
Yeah.
And God told him, Go down to this brook right here, and I'm gonna command these ravens to take care of you. And then when that brook dried up, then God told him, "Look, said this, go down to Zarephath and this widow and her son. They will feed you and take care of you." Somebody say, "Amen."
Amen.
See, the thing about it, when you really intimate with God, God's gonna always be one step ahead of you. God's gonna be always going before you. God's gonna be already leading you into the next place to go. He'll lead you into the next place to go. So there's no worry, God. Somebody say, "Amen."
Amen.
Now, the thing that you must understand about God and the intimacy with God, see, God will give you strength. And when people come against you, when people try to stab you, or they try to assassinate you or hurt you, God will protect you. God will become a shield around you. God will become your buckler. God will become your strength. God will become your guide. Somebody say amen.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Now, it's just like the Red Sea. When the children of Israel came out of Egypt, and they were headed to the Red Sea, and as they got to the Red Sea, they looked back and they saw Pharaoh's army coming.
Uh-huh.
Coming at them in hot pursuit. And they cried out to the Lord. And the Bible said that God was a cloud to them by day. But also, God became a cloud of darkness behind them.
Yeah.
Which meant that God allowed the enemy to not see them. Uh-huh. That God called the enemy to not see where they were. And see, when you with God, and when you're doing the will of God, God will cause things that try to overtake you.
Uh-huh.
He will cause things that try to come against you where you can't see, where they can't see you.
You're
called to let it come in you, can't touch you. Somebody say amen.
Amen. Amen.
Come on, get the Lord a hand clap.
Amen.
Now, the thing about seeing as well and the secret place, when you really have the seed of God in, when you have an intimate relationship with God, the Bible says that in the Matthew, the 5th chapter, the 24th verse, it says that when you have a gift, and you want to offer that gift unto God, the Bible says, if
Come on.
Lay your gifts down.
And
go to your brother and restore them. Now consider yourself and restore them in a spirit of meekness.
Yes.
See, the problem with many people of why that many God's people are not really getting blessed is because they're playing, but God's not listening to them because they have all against somebody.
Come on now.
Or even if I'm saying that, if you remember that somebody got all against you, you got to go get that right. Because if you don't get that right, then God ain't going to answer your prayer.
Come on now.
Also, the Bible says that in the book of Chronicles, the first part of the 7th chapter in the 14th verse, it was during the time of Solomon when he was praying to God and he offered a sacrifice up to God for God to accept him and the people. Mm-hmm. And God said that if my people, which are called by my name, would humble themselves and pray, turn from their wicked ways, seek my face, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sins and heal the land. See, there's many people who even accept Christ. They're still wicked.
My God.
Many people who say they accept Christ, they're still mean.
Come on now.
Because see what happens with people a lot of times, and this is so important, is they'll bring their bad ways, and they'll bring their bad attitude, they'll bring their disrespectful
self
into the house of God.
Say so.
And they'll try to cheat God.
Come on.
And God's people, just like they treat people in the world.
So, and it don't work.
And the problem with that also is that they're in many churches. And the Bible says that if they stand in my counsel, they're going to change their ways.
Come on now.
So which means that if someone is preaching the word, per se, and the people go in one way,
say so,
and they go out the same way, I got a problem with that preacher. Because if it's the word of God, gonna challenge him.
Come on now.
The word of God gonna do one or two things. It's gonna change him or it's gonna make him leave. Now we ain't talking about membership. We ain't talking about time and offer. Because there's something about the time and offer too. See, preachers don't talk about the time and offer. In the days of old, the Bible says that your heart had to be a certain way.
Come on.
Because if your heart was contentious, or if you had malice in your heart, God will accept that gift.
God will accept it.
So there are many people who are paying tithes and offers in church, and they're on the usher board.
Come on.
They're paying tithes and offers in church. They're in the choirs.
Come on.
They're sister pastors.
Jesus.
They become deacons and all that.
Jesus.
And a lot of times, those preachers are doing that because they're